good morning from Disney's Animal Kingdom theme park parking lot. Very excited today. We're here to see all the Christmas decorations.
Yay.
And the snacks. Gonna try 3 snacks. That's the goal. We'll see if we finish all 3 of those today.
Plus a lovely late lunch, early dinner at Yak and Yeti.
Very true.
My first time at that restaurant, so we're excited to try it out and tell you what we think.
Exactly. So, let's go.
So, holiday snack number 1 here at Animal Kingdom is the Santa Mickey mousse from Creature Comforts, so the Starbucks location, and it is a white chocolate peppermint mousse dome on top of a brownie. So, pretty excited for this one. I know we're both peppermint fans, so we shall see. Take a bite. The mousse is good. It smells more pepperminty than it tastes. I expect it to be more overpowering.
I just want to eat this all the time. Just the mousse part.
It is very good. The brownie is very, very firm.
I didn't get any brownie. I'm still trying to cut the brownie with my spoon.
Yeah.
Still so going.
Probably not the greatest quality brownie, but the mousse itself is very good. This one was $5.99, I believe. I'll put the price down below, but yeah. So far, I would say holiday snack number 1's a success. Okay, so we just finished our brownie mousse extravaganza
thing.
Final thoughts. The peppermint mousse itself, the peppermint flavor did kind of grow exponentially as you ate it. Seemed like the middle was very pepperminty, but could have just been we were eating it and our flavors have been changing. The brownie, very dense.
It's thick.
Could have done with
thick brownie.
Either a cakeier brownie or like you said, a cookie.
Yeah. When we were eating it, I was like, I don't need all this.
Yeah.
But I know we said before we like peppermint, so
Yes. Maybe
if you're not quite a peppermint person, you would appreciate there being more brownie and less peppermint,
true.
But I could take or leave the brownie.
Yeah, but the mousse itself was very good. We'd get it again.
I just want to scrape the top off the brownie, though.
Yeah, and then something else to note is it comes from Creature Comforts, and it comes in a little like plastic container like this, which is nice because if you don't finish the whole thing, you can take it home. It's kind of keeps it upright and whatnot.
Or if you need something to take home.
Yeah. So.
Not even touch it in the park.
Right. Exactly. So if it's like something you want to grab anyway out the door, easy to take this and just make sure it gets home in one piece. So, but that was a nice aspect. But yeah, that was a great snack. And then onwards to our next snack. Okay, holiday snack number two for Animal Kingdom. We actually got this one to go. And once again, from the Starbucks, and they gave us a nice little dome container to take it home, which was not the easiest thing because it was wobbling around quite a bit, but easier than just on a plate. So.
But we were the envy of all who saw us with our cupcake in a dome.
Yes, there was the cast member at the...
The security cast member.
Yeah, and somebody else too.
Multiple people were like, oh, that looks good.
That's true. Oh, it was it's about to be a bug.
Yes.
So yeah, people were very excited that we had this cupcake. But this is the Menagerie cupcake, kind of paying homage to the last year. They had the Menagerie puppet-looking things, animals walking around. They do not have it this year for COVID reasons, but hopefully it comes back in the future because they did look pretty cool. But yeah, this is a gingerbread cupcake with cream cheese frosting and then a white chocolate polar bear on top. So, let's give it a try. The top is very sweet. The cake is gingerbread. It's pretty spicy, like the gingerbread spice. Very like nutmeggy coming through. It's very good though.
I love a good spice cake.
Yeah.
I love a good carrot cake, so. But this does have like a bit of a kick to it.
Yeah, there's quite a bit of the gingerbread spice to it, for sure.
The frosting doesn't taste
cream cheese-y
to me.
The sugar on top is a weird crunch, but yeah, I'm not getting
cream cheese. But does that keep me from eating it? No.
Maybe it's not cream cheese. I'll put the complete description.
Are we crazy?
Below, but
is it not cream cheese?
Maybe it's not. Definitely gingerbread though. Mm-hmm. Definitely gingerbread cake. The cake is very good.
And it's big. It's a big dessert.
Yeah, very big. How would you rank this compared to the Christmas tree cupcake in Magic Kingdom?
Oh, we're throwing it back to Magic Kingdom?
Since that was, yeah.
I mean, this is better than the Christmas tree cupcake.
Yeah, this is probably one of the best Disney cupcakes that I've had.
Especially for a Starbucks cupcake.
Yeah, so this is available at Starbucks and at Flame Tree Barbecue.
Oh.
We got it from Starbucks because we knew that they had the domes. So for to-go purposes, we got it from Starbucks. But yeah, this was very good. We'd get this again. This was the same price as the Moose Dome. I feel like you get a lot more with this.
Right. But I just want to eat the top of the Moose Dome.
Yeah. The Moose had a good peppermint. I don't know how I'd rank those two. I'd probably put this as number one. Just because the brownie was kind of flop.
If I'm just ranking, like, the Moose itself, the Moose would be number one, the brownie would be three, and this would be two. But if I can't do that, then we'll put this as number one.
Yeah. So... Yeah, overall, I would say this one's very good. I'm afraid to eat the cute little polar bear. But
he's too cute.
He is white chocolate, but we'll have to give him a try as well. But yeah, snack number two, success. We did try to get a third snack today, but it was closed when we got there, so we are going back to Animal Kingdom, but for you it'll be the same video. So we will give that a try. Okay, we are here for day two in Animal Kingdom. Trying snack number three for the holidays. This is the chocolate peppermint ice cream sandwich from Dino Bites in Dinoland.
It's also in the 60s today.
Yes. A little chilly today, but I still want to try this one, so let's give it a try. It's very good. Nice peppermint flavor to it. The candy cane crushed is a lot. Kind of gets all over your hands. But flavor-wise, very good. This is one of the more expensive ones too. This was $7.45 after tax, so I think the most expensive one we had here,
right. But
it is pretty good, and it's huge too.
Right, definitely shareable.
Yes, I mean, for perspective purposes, like, after two bites, it's still a giant cookie sandwich, so yeah, I would definitely get this again, for sure.
On a warmer day.
On a warmer day, yes.
Yes, what I mean.
Back in the car after our second day at Animal Kingdom. So overall, what were your thoughts on the holiday offerings here?
I think this park is really strong on the holiday offerings.
Yeah, I
agree.
With
all the decorations, the nighttime projections are very, very cute.
Yes, I do like the tree projections quite a bit. They did change pretty frequently as well. Mm-hmm. And they were long, like, shows. More so
like three and a half, 4 minutes straight.
Right, telling a story, and then like maybe 5 minutes in between each one or so.
Maybe.
It was pretty quick. So quite a few of those, and those were fun to see. As far as decorations go, there were tons.
They have, I was going to say about the projections, I think their projections are the best out of all the parks.
Yeah, I agree.
Because Epcot
didn't do anything.
Hollywood's were cute, and I like that they were consistently moving.
Right.
But they weren't the easiest to see on the tower.
And then with the tower having, like, taken the pictures of the riders, every now and then you just see, like, a flash of white. So that was kind of a downside of the tower versus the castle projections in Magic Kingdom.
Magic was nice, but I wish it moved a little faster than 15 minutes.
Right. But then these are telling a story. It's like it's more of a show versus like a
photo op.
Photo op. So highly recommend checking these out if you haven't seen these before. As far as the decorations go, everywhere was pretty heavily decorated except for Asia. Mm-hmm. But they put up lights, which I'm not sure if those were there
Dino
before.
Dinoland went crazy.
Dinoland, yeah, for whatever reason, a lot of like the retro throwback type of decorations.
The music is just blaring in there.
Yes.
All of Dinoland is rocking out.
Yes. And then Africa is also pretty well decorated. A lot of like looks like hand-carved or handmade items in the garlands, so those were nice to see. Pandora wasn't really decorated, but that also makes sense because there's only a couple humans that are in the story, so I'm okay with that not being too heavily decorated. And then the Discovery Island area was also pretty heavily decorated as well. A lot of garlands, a lot of like the lanterns, and so yeah, very cool decorations here. Then as far as the snacks go,
this isn't the best park for the snacks for Christmas.
Yeah, I really wanted to like these snacks.
I feel like there were things that were problematic with all of them.
Yes, the mousse dome thing, the peppermint one, had a fantastic mousse, but the brownie was not the greatest.
Yeah.
And then the gingerbread cupcake was good.
The menagerie cupcake.
Yes, the menagerie cupcake was good, but then as we were eating it, we did find the cream cheese in the middle.
Which, like, why not just do the same frosting on top of the cupcake as inside the cupcake?
Right. And the cream cheese was much better with it. It did pair much nicer. But it was a spicy cake. Like, it was...
Yeah, it was very, a lot.
Very, very heavily gingerbread spiced. And then the peppermint chocolate chip or chocolate cookie sandwich, ice cream sandwich, it tasted pepperminty at first, but the ice cream itself was not peppermint, so it was just the first bite when the candy cane crushed around it was pepperminty, but
it was hard
that,
to eat, too. Yes. It was really hard to eat.
Very, very messy.
It just squished out.
Yeah. So,
not a snack I'd recommend for little ones.
No, very, yeah. And on a hot day, I'm sure, with the chocolate melting and everything. Luckily, it, I mean, colder today for
luckily,
ice cream.
It's only 61 degrees Fahrenheit.
So it didn't melt quite as fast, but yeah. I think Magic probably had the best snack options. So, but yeah. And then as far as the flotillas go here, we didn't get to catch the... We did see it, but we didn't get to film it. The Goofy with Chip and Dale dressed as dinosaurs, dressed as reindeer for the holiday. But
which is a lot.
It is a lot. But we did see the rest of the cavalcades, and those were pretty cute. All of them were holiday except for Pocahontas, and then we saw a Rafiki one in the distance.
From far away, we saw Timon and Rafiki just doing their thing.
But the Mickey one was cute, all dressed in the holiday attire, and Santa was good as always. The drummers were cool to see.
Mm-hmm. They seem to be having fun, too.
Yeah. So, overall, I think Animal Kingdom's pretty up there for the holiday atmosphere. Mm-hmm. I would say probably right behind Magic. I'd still put Magic as number one just because it has the atmosphere of Main Street and whatnot, but I'd put Animal Kingdom as number two, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Overall. So...
Bold statement.
Yeah. I never thought I would.
At least
say
for 2020.
Yeah, at least for this year. I'm sure next year, assuming things will change by then, I think next year will be a little bit different for all the parks, but we shall see. But I think that's going to do it for us here today. And I know this one's going to be going up towards the end of the month. So happy New Year, everybody. And we will see you next time.
See you real soon. Joy to the world.